Is the slide visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, thank you. Let me see who are there waiting. Okay. Yes, which list? Now, see here, we have started to discuss in the last class about Modi Gyani and Miller, his approach in case of dividend policy. You have already studied Modi Gyani Miller as a part of capital structure, but here I am going to discuss in relation to the dividend policy. And you by now I think you have understood there is a very close relationship between the two, the capital structure and the dividend. And the profitability, the calculation of profit, and the payment of dividend part that we are finding. And we have discussed this part. There are perfect, these are the assumptions which have been made by these two people. And one assumption that was dropped also, that is, there is no risk or uncertainty, which in the beginning they have considered, but after some time they have dropped this, that okay, this is not going to be. And their argument also, they are good. That whatever increase in the value of the firm results from the payment of dividend will be exactly offset by the decline in the market price of the share. Because of external financing, and there will be no change in the total wealth of the shareholder, we have considered this. Now I am coming to the very typical side of this Modigliani and Miller's approach. Why I say that it is the typical side? Because the derivations, whatever we are going to discuss here, and the type of calculation which will be made based on these derivations, they are very much important. And there are so many things which will be arising in between, but the basic understanding we have to keep in mind. So just to refresh that, I am telling you that we are interested in calculating the position of the firm. So in terms of one share or in terms of the total value of the firm, we will be calculating. And finally, with the help of this algebraic expression, they have tried to prove that the dividend is not going to affect the value of the firm or the value, individual value of the share. So their main focus of whatever derivations we are going to discuss now is on explaining that it is the dividend is not the determinant factor in the valuation of the firm. And for that, they have gone through this particular process, and which we have to understand very simply so that these assumptions and all these aspects, they will also be coming in between. So a somewhat longer description, you can say, or the derivation through which we will have to go now. Now see, his assumption is that the return and the cost of capital or the discount rate, he is considering that they are identical. They are same, they are constant, they are identical. So rate of return, it means they have basically considered that it is a normal firm. If you are going in the terminology of Walter and Gordon, so in that terminology, you will say that okay, it is just like a normal firm. But, and here for the purpose of calculation, this part we are going to take up. So R and K, and they are identical for all shares. So the rate of return will be calculated as, now see, this is the rate of return. So rate of return, he is calculating on the basis of what? There are two components of the return to the shareholder. There are two components of return to the shareholder, we know that. All right. One is the dividend component, and this dividend will be declared at the end of the period. That's why we are writing dividend 1. See, most of the time we are writing this 1 as a subscript. So you will be finding in the book it is written just like subscript, and here also I have used it, but in some cases you will find that okay, I have gone by 1, 2, or 0, not as a subscript, but so you should have to keep in mind it should be written as a subscript. Now see the component. One is the dividend component, very clear. You have purchased the share, you are expecting at the end of the year when the calculation of profit will be made, and the company is going to declare dividend, I will be getting it. So this is one return which the shareholder is going to get. And what is another return? The another return is the capital gain. And what is this capital gain? Capital gain is the difference of price of the share during that period. So if you have purchased the share for 15 rupees and you are going to sell it for 18 rupees, so it will be the 3 rupees capital gain. So purchase price, that is P0, and purchase price, that is P0, and the sale price we are going to make after difference, that is P1. So the selling price, that is P1, and the purchase price is the P0, so the difference of the two. All right, so dividend is one component and the capital gain is the another component. And he has assumed, they have assumed in a different manner that okay, the capital gain and the dividend, there is no difference in terms of taxes, and there is no difference in terms of their return. So many assumptions they have already made in this case. We have discussed that. So the return will be calculated in what manner? Dividend 1 and the capital gain of on the sale of the share. About this capital gain, I tell you, we are calculating capital gain throughout. We will be using that for the purpose of valuation of the share. But the capital gain will arise when we are actually going to sell the share and we are getting the benefit of it, because the taxation will be made only when the actual operation that takes place. It is not on the basis of expectation. We are very much clear about that. If the money is coming to the business, then only we are going to charge. So the taxes will be calculated only when you are going to operate or you are going to implement the purchase and sale. But for the purpose of valuation, we are considering that okay, what is the value of share in the marketplace, we are considering it, and for what value I have purchased it, this is another part. So what we are considering in this case, we are considering number one, that the dividend which will be received at the end of the year, and this part also we are considering that it will be at the end of the year. So what you have to do, you are going to get it after 1 year, so it will have to be discounted. Okay, so the capital gain, that is going to be discounted. So this part we have to do here. So dividend 1 plus price 1 divided by, when you are going to calculate P0 and you are going to solve this equation, you will be finding it like this. So 1 divided by R, because R is coming here. So this dividend 1 plus P1. So price, P0 is the price in the beginning. P1 is the price at the end of the period. So we have started from here and we are going to calculate it at this stage. So we have taken up. So this has become the discounting factor, 1 plus R. Now see here, R and K, they have been considered as similar. So here they have changed it from P0, dividend 1 plus P1, which is R has been changed to K. K is the cost of capital. They have assumed that this return and the cost of capital, they are same, because this is based on the assumption of the normal firm. So R and K, they are going to be same. So this is the derivation which we are finding. Now see what they are saying. It is for one share, because this is P0, it is for one share. Now the value of the firm will be multiplying both the sides by the number of shares. So it's here NP0, whatever is the number. So it is for one share, so we will be multiplying this P0 by the number of shares, and this will also be multiplied by the number of shares. So in that case, the value will be, so this side multiplied by N and this side will also be multiplied by N. Equation is going to be balanced. All right. So now considering this, the value of the firm, now this is not the value of the share, this has become the value of the firm. So NP0 is equal to N, that is the multiplication part, dividend 1 plus P1, and that is being divided by 1 plus K. So we are getting at the end, so we are going to discount it. If we add and subtract the number of new shares, now see here why we are considering this. The number of new shares issued at the time 1, we will be getting the equation like this. See, why we are considering, I am going to shift it to the other slide so that you should not be concentrating on that slide. See, in case of this, Modigliani and Miller approach, what they say? They are not adopting the assumption as they have been adopted in case of Walter and Gordon models, that there is no external financing. Here they have accepted that there is external financing. That means if the company has got investment opportunity, the company is not going to depend only on the retained earning or the profit. The company will be going for the issue of additional shares. So you have to keep this point in mind. The company, in the assumption in this case is that the company will be going for the issue of additional shares in the market. No matter what would be its position in terms of its control or in terms of voting or in terms of the total value, that part will be discussed at the later stage. So they have assumed that for the purpose of financing their investment, the company will be going for issue of additional shares in the market. Now there is a question. When the company is going to issue share in the market, what will be the price of the share which the company will charge? Because the company is going to issue shares in the market, naturally the company will have to charge the price. Based on that, the money will be coming to the business. So here the question is that what will be the price of the share which the company is going to issue in the market? So they are considering that, okay, we will be considering this price as P1. Okay, this is one. When you are going to consider P1 as the price, then the question is that how many shares we have to issue? Next, the question is, suppose the price you have fixed, that okay, we are going to sell the share for 18 rupees or 15 rupees, then the question will be there for financing our investment, how many shares they will have to be issued. So here in this case, what they have done with this formula, they have, here they say, if we add and subtract the number of new shares issued at the time 1, we will get the equation like this. So NP0, N dividend 1 plus P1, now they have added. What is there? What they have added? This is M. M is the number of new shares issued. M is the number of new shares issued, and that will be issued at price P1. So they have added MP1 and they have reduced MP1. We are, in case of algebraic expression, we are doing this thing for the purpose of our own. So here what they say that, okay, number of new shares M we are going to issue at price P1, and the same amount we are going to reduce from the formula, we will be, so the equation will remain balanced. You understand that there is no doubt about it. I am not going to discuss any further. So it's the value of the firm, which was like this: number of shares multiplied by dividend at the time 1 plus price of the share at the time 1 divided by 1 plus K, which is the discounting factor based on the return or the cost of equity. Now they say that for the purpose of financing investment, we have to issue additional shares. No problem. So how many shares we will be issuing? So they say that, okay, whatever share we are going to issue, the number will be this much, and the price will be this much. So same amount we are going to add and same amount we are going to reduce. This will become zero if you are going to consider this. Naturally, so, but this is going to help us in the calculation. Now see what is happening. The further explanation is here. This MP0, that is the value of the firm, that is equal to the number of shares, and this, so this bracket they have said that okay, we are going to be to keep this over. So n dividend 1 plus n p1, there is no problem about it, you understand this, plus n p1 minus n p1. Any doubt about it? I don't think. So here what they have done, they have divided, they have multiplied dividend 1 by the number of shares. They have also multiplied price by the number of shares. So the n dividend, that has become the dividend, the total amount and of dividend, and this is the total shares at the time of at the end time. MP1 minus MP1, which we have added and subtracted here, they have also been written here. Now see, in the next stage what they have done. MP0, now this N dividend 1, that is same. MP1 and MP1, they have taken the help of these two. What they have done? They have taken common. That is P1 they have taken as common. So what is remaining in between? It is N plus MP1. Generally, we are writing in Indian case, we will be writing P1 first, and then we will be writing N and M. But here we are writing N, M. So it has been, simply it is a placement, otherwise there is no difference. So what we have done? The existing share plus new share. This is the existing share, MP1 at price 1. It is the new share at price 1. So this will become the total share at the price 1, okay, minus MP1 divided by 1 plus K. So NP0, the value of the firm, that is N dividend 1 plus NP1 multiplied by P1 minus MP1 divided by 1 plus K. So the value of the firm, when we are going to issue additional share and we are going to reduce it, we will be finding it like this. So the equation is still balanced, okay. Now see here what he says. This is very important. Try to understand this, because some new notations, they are also coming. Number of new shares, that is M, issued can be calculated as under. Because here in this equation, we are finding this M. We are finding M also. So what is this M? We have calculated by price 1. We are knowing dividend 1. So this number of, how many shares we will require. So that number of shares that will be calculated like this. What is the basis? The basis is investment. Just let me check. There are some who are waiting, I think. Yes. Okay. See here. Why you are going to issue share? The reason is that there is some investment opportunity available. That investment is your I. What is this? This is not the beginning. We are considering that, okay, investment opportunity we are going to consider at the time, the latter time. So this is investment 1. Or you can simply write I, that will also work. This I is the total amount which are required. You are having some money from the operations of your business. So this is the second story. The first story is over here. Try to keep in mind. The first story, that is over here. This is the second story related to that, of course. That is the starting now. We are having investment opportunity, okay. We have also got profit from the business, but net profit for the year, they have written X or X1. That's up to you. Okay. When you are going to declare dividend, then what will happen? After declaring dividend, whatever is the remaining part which will be available for financing your investment. Try to understand, you are having some investment requirement I, that is there. You have earned some amount of profit from the operations of business, that is X. Out of this profit, you are going to declare dividend, okay. So X minus 1. It will be, and then in that case, you are going to declare dividend. So how much dividend you are going to declare? Dividend per share multiplied by the number of share. So X minus N dividend 1 you will be doing. That will be the remaining part for financing investment. How many additional shares you will require? Investment minus प्रॉफिट माइनस द डिविडेंड व्हाट एवर यू हैव पेड. तो ट्राई टू सी हियर नाउ, दिस इज योर इन्वेस्टमेंट रिक्वायरमेंट. तो फ्रॉम दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट हाउ मच एडिशनल मनी विल बी रिक्वायर्ड, आई दैट इज योर इन्वेस्टमेंट रिक्वायरमेंट. फ्रॉम हियर दिस इज नथिंग, दिस इज द रिटेन अर्निंग एक्स वन माइनस एन डिविडेंड वन, दैट इज नथिंग, इट इज द रिटेन अर्निंग. हाउ यू हैव कैलकुलेटेड दिस रिटेन अर्निंग, दिस इज द टोटल प्रॉफिट माइनस द डिविडेंड व्हाट एवर यू हैव पेड. हाउ आर यू कैलकुलेटिंग दिस डिविडेंड पेड, नंबर ऑफ शेयर्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द डिविडेंड पर शेयर. तो दिस इज द अमाउंट ऑफ योर प्रॉफिट माइनस डिविडेंड पेड. तो दिस इज द अमाउंट विच इज अवेलेबल फॉर फाइनेंसिंग योर इन्वेस्टमेंट. तो फ्रॉम दिस इन्वेस्टमेंट दिस रिटेन अर्निंग दैट इज गोइंग टू बी रिड्यूस्ड आफ्टर इट्स रिडक्शन, व्हाट एवर इज द अमाउंट दैट विल बी गोइंग फॉर द for the issue of shares. So what is happening in this case, or NP1, how many shares, how much money you will require, investment minus your profit plus your end dividend, because this bracket has gone. So algebraic expression is like this now, this investment minus your profit plus your dividend 1, you will be getting it. Now see here, substituting the value we get. Now see, NP0 coming to this side, we have got, now coming to this, we have got the value of the sum N dividend 1 plus N plus P1 minus NP1 divided by 1 plus K. N plus NP1, and this we are going to consider, this we are going to retain. N plus NP1 we are going to retain, and we are going to replace the value of NP1. Try to see it, because due to changing the slide, sometimes you will be missing this. See this, this expression. N plus NP1 we are going to retain. We have got the value of MP1, which is the additional amount to be received from the market by sale of new shares. This is the amount which we have to collect from the market by the issue of new share. How have you calculated? It is here. We have considered the investment amount, we have considered the profit, we have considered the dividend. Based on that, this is the amount which will be required, MP1. How we are going to calculate? I minus profit plus dividend 1. So this minus plus is coming due to this. Now see here, MP1, what is this? MP1 is equal to I minus X1 plus N dividend 1. So what we are doing, this MP1, which was there in that formula, we are going to replace it here. So N dividend 1 plus NP1 minus MP1. So this minus MP1 will become I minus X1 plus N dividend 1. We are going to write it like this. I will be coming to the other part of it. So is it clear now? If it is not, I am going back.
Yes, sir. Sir, I have a doubt.
Oh, yes, please tell me.
So first thing is that what is this one denoting all these letters?
One.
So this number one, what is this actually denoting in all these letters?
See here. You will be finding this number one and zero. All right. I should have written it as a this subscript, and you will find in the book as subscript. See, whenever we are writing any amount and we are writing zero, it means it is the present form or it is the present price. So this is the price of the share now, P0, and this is the P1. It is after a period of time, generally what we are considering. In case of dividend or in any type of return, we are going to get this return after a period of time. So what we will be writing, we will be writing P1. So to make a difference, P0 is the price in the beginning, P1 is the price at the end of the year. Dividend we are paying, dividend will be paid at the end of the year. So whether you are writing dividend one or you are not writing dividend one, you are simply writing dividend, it will work. But we are going to, just for the purpose of understanding that, okay, the dividend will be paid at the end of the year, we are writing one. So this one is at the end of the year. So P1, price at the end of the year, dividend one, that is the dividend at the end of the year. So this is one part. So this is MP1. So this is the number of shares which you are going to issue. M, at what price you will be issuing. You are dealing with the investment. This will be done at the later part of this period. So we will be pricing our share as P1. So here MP1 or MP1, they are the part of the price of the share at the end of the period. P0 is the present value. P0 is the present position of the price of the share. So the P0 or P1, they are the part of the denominations we have made in terms of the present and the future. So dividend we are paying at the end of the period. So we will be writing one. If we are not writing one, even then the dividend will work. But there will be difference. There will be a problem in case of P0 and P1. Because the price at the end of the period and the price in the beginning, they will be different. So here in this case, now I am coming to this. Here we have come to this stage. We have replaced MP1 by I minus X1 plus N dividend 1. So this is the minus sign. So the minus sign will remain I minus X1 plus N dividend 1. All right. Now see what is it. Of course, this will be divided by 1 plus K. Now see here, NP0, N dividend 1 plus N plus MP1, there is no problem up to this stage because this is the same. Minus investment plus your return minus, because this bracket is over. So minus investment which you are making at the end of the period, this X1 you are getting, this is the profit which you are getting. And this then minus dividend which you are paying at the end of the period. All right, divided by 1 plus K. Now see here, N dividend 1, this is plus, this is minus. All right, they will be cancelled. So what will happen now? N dividend 1 and minus N dividend 1. Algebraic expression, they say that, okay, they will be cancelled. So what is remaining now? The remaining part is the existing share plus new share, so N plus M P1 minus I, that is your investment, plus X1 divided by 1 plus K. Up to this, any problem?
What is this X?
X is your profit.
Okay, sir.
Okay. I have written. See here, net profit for the year is X. Somewhere you will find they will be writing P, but in case of writing P, the problem is here. You got price of the share. So they may be using other denominations, other mark also for that purpose. I, that is your investment, they will be writing I and V also for investment purpose. So you will find that different denotation. So X is your profit, I is your investment. So if suppose you are not paying dividend, then what will happen? I minus X1, that will be the money required for investment purpose. When you are going to pay dividend, and dividend will be paid from the profit. So from profit, we are going to reduce it. The simple logic that goes like this. Okay. Now try to see here. Where from have we started? Try to see the typical situation, whatever we are finding. We have started from here. Return we have started to calculate. From this return, we have calculated the value of the share, the price. This we have calculated. We have converted to 1 by. So we have started from here. Basically, you can say that, okay, we are continuing with the valuation of the share, that is P0. What is here? Dividend 1 plus P1 divided by 1 plus K. By adding, by deleting, by investing, we have come to this stage. And we have gone to the process of valuation. What is here now? This is the existing share, this is the new share, and the price P1, this is investment, this is profit, divided by 1 plus K. Now they are saying that where is the dividend? Where is the dividend now? Dividend is not there in the formula now. They started calculation from the dividend itself. They were the dividend and the capital gain. These two components, they were the part of their return. But now they say that, okay, now we have come to this stage, investment opportunity is available, market price we have considered, additional shares we have issued for the purpose of financing investment, and the dividend is not there. That's why they have, at the end, they said that whether you pay dividend or you do not pay dividend, the value of the share is not going to be affected. So the payment of dividend, the non-payment of dividend, they have taken up this particular part by taking into account that when you are going to make your investment opportunity, you are going to pay dividend, or if you are not going to pay dividend, that will be adjusted in your investment opportunity, and at the end, the dividend is not there in the formula. So whether you are going to pay dividend or you are not going to pay dividend, it is not going to affect the value of the firm. But here they have considered that there is an investment opportunity, they have considered that there is profit component available, they have also considered that the additional shares they will be issued, so there is external financing available. If they are not going to issue the equity share, they will be going to issue the debenture, that will be the another option. But they have gone to calculate the value of the firm, that is NP0, at the present value of the firm, and they said that, okay, existing share plus additional share at the price P1 minus your investment plus your profit divided by 1 plus K, that is the equalization factor, there is no dividend. You have started with dividend, you have gone to the stage where there is no dividend. Now see here, this is the formula which we are using for the purpose of our understanding, and the logic that goes like this. So these are the different steps which we have to understand. And I have tried to explain it, and I think this will be there with you. Now see, based on this, we are going to have a very simple example. See, and I am coming to...
Sir, yes, please. Sir, I have one last class.
Yes.
Sir, I have another class.
Oh, how much time? What is the time, sir?
Not 20, sir.
आज कितने 40 मिनट की क्लास है 45 मिनट की कितने की 40 मिनट्स ऑफ 45 मिनट्स
सर 40 मिनट की क्लास
40 की क्लास है अगर 45 होती हुई तो 25 आई है चलिए साहब फिर क्या किया जाए तो फिर कल फिर रखा जाएगा इसको टुमारो एट 8:50 इंशाल्लाह वी आर मीटिंग